Smog Is Made. The first ingredients are called the precursors. You have sulfur dioxide, and you have your nitrogen oxides. To prepare the precursors, you start by burning stuff. Now, if you want to create enough smog to pollute the air of a large city, you're going to have to burn a lot of stuff, and dirty stuff, too. To generate these precursors, two of the things that I like to burn are coal and gasoline. In addition to forming one of the basic building blocks of smog, burning coal has the added benefit of being useful to generate electricity, so you can charge your phones and watch your TV. You can light, power, and cool your home. And even when you're not at home, you can help contribute to smog precursors by just leaving the lights on and the air condition on, especially if you have a big house with lots of rooms to keep cool and well lit. You can even sleep with the TV on. And burning gasoline has its benefits too. Besides the pollution it creates, the process can be used to power automobiles and farm equipment, and to transport food from farms thousands of miles away by airplane to local stores. And in an ordinary automobile, you don't even have to drive far to help make smog. It just takes persistence. You can just sit in traffic on your way to work every day for just a few short miles and listen to my music while you relax. Now I know what you're thinking. Most of this coal burning and driving happens outside the city, and we want the smog in the city, where we work and breathe for hours and hours every day. Okay, I get it. But luckily we have wind, glorious wind, that blows the precursors to the cities, out from the smokestacks of the coal burning power plants to the west, and over the beautiful Appalachian Mountains, where maybe some acid can be deposited on a nice rainy day, and into the cities of the Boswash Corridor. Now the sun is rising and we add our on-site ingredients, the volatile organic compounds. Pretty much anything man-made that smells funny. There's plenty of fumes coming out of those tailpipes and I smell smoke, aerosol sprays, laundry room steam, perfumes, and rotting trash. What happens next is an amazing series of photochemical reactions where the remote precursors and the VOCs interact with all the natural energy from the sunlight to generate a mixture of ground-level ozone and tiny particles of hazardous toxins. It's that lovely yellowish-brown hazy stuff we call smog.